I got a few requests for the recording of this session. So we are recording this session, and later on, if you people want, we can share the recorded version also. So I will start now with the presentation. So guys, it's MBR technology. Like we use various kind of technology in the sewage treatment plant, like conventional treatment, or most of the people are using MBR or MBBR kind of things. So here and today we are going to talk about the MBR, membrane bioreactor technology. So why to choose MBR? Let's decide the first question. Like we use various kind of technology. Sometimes we use conventional MBBR, SBR. Nowadays the MBR technology is very getting famous in the various kind of industries. So why to choose MBR technology? So first and foremost thing, if you are genuinely looking for the class A water quality, when I say class A water quality, it means that BOD and COD, these are the two parameters where we normally check to in laboratory to check the water quality. So if you're BOD and COD, if you are looking for less than 5 BOD and 30 COD, and you are looking for a very clear and very transparent water, let's say you are looking for a 1 PSS and 1 turbidity. So water has to be very clean, like a drinking water, but it's a non-potable water. So if you are looking for a class A water quality, yes, MBR is for you. Number two, if you are looking for a reusing of the 100% water. So when I say 100% treated water, it means that most of the time, kya hota hai ki, let's say commercial building ke andar, you are having around 5 lakh liter wastewater coming out from your commercial building. But out of 5 lakh liter, you just want to recycle only 10 and 20% of the water. In such case, MBR may not be commercially viable to all of you. So in case, if you want to recycle 100% wastewater which is coming out from your premises, and you want to recycle 100% water, then certainly MBR is for you. So this is the second criteria. Thirdly, if you are having very limited area, so like there are two kind of basic technologies or process, you can say, which is anaerobic and aerobic technology. Anaerobic technologies, traditionally we used to make a big and large capacity of the septic tank with the 4-day retention, 5-day retention, or 10-day retention or more, depend what is your wastewater inlet quality. But anaerobic technology consume very large area of the treatment plant. If you go for the conventional technology, then slightly lower than anaerobic technology. Then gradually, जैसे जैसे हम लोग technology के ऊपर जाते हैं, conventional to MBBR or SBR, your area of the plant construction goes reduce. तो अगर आपके पास इतना भी area नहीं है कि आप conventional MBBR या SBR technology को नहीं set कर सकते आपकी premises के अंदर, MBR technology is for you. So this is the third criteria, which is your area. The fourth is, you want to keep a minimum operator intervention. Usually, I am getting some personal message. Hope everybody can listen me. If somebody is not able to listen me, do type your message in the chat box. So this is for, and fourth thing, if you want to make a fully automatic sewage treatment plant, or you are looking for a minimum operator intervention, then MBR is for you, because most of the time MBR technology based jitne bhi wastewater treatment plant or sewage treatment plant, those plants will not be fully automatic or wo operator driven hote hain. Like you require might be 1 operator, 2 operator, 3 operator with these certain kind of helpers, depend upon the capacity of your plant. So these are 4 criteria. If you are looking for a minimum operator intervention, MBR technology is for you. The fifth is, if you are looking for a user-friendly wastewater treatment plant, like when I, so these 2 points, number 4 and number 5, are related. Like, agar aap plant ko fully automatic bana rahe, so definitely user-friendly it would be there. So now you can connect your plant to the various kind of software. You can do the SCADA-based plant. You can provide various kind of instrumentation into the sewage treatment plant. And if you are looking for some kind of online monitoring system, ki mujhe online TSS check karna ya, flow check karna ya, pressure check karna, so those kind of parameters, with the installation of the good instrumentation in the sewage treatment plant, you can have on your software, or you can have in the SCADA based services. तो अगर आप फुल्ली ऑटोमेटिक प्लांट पे जा रहे हैं तो यूजर फ्रेंडली वेस्ट वाटर ट्रीटमेंट प्लांट होना चाहिए, मतलब देयर इज नो डाउट अबाउट दैट. दिस इज अ टिपिकल फ्लो चार्ट ऑफ योर कन्वेंशनल सीवेज ट्रीटमेंट प्लांट और वेस्ट वाटर ट्रीटमेंट प्लांट एंड एमबीआर प्लांट. सो इफ यू सी दैट कन्वेंशनल सीवेज ट्रीटमेंट प्लांट इज रिक्वायर वन एरियोबिक टैंक्स वेयर एडिशन टेक्नोलॉजी प्रोसेस इज हैपनिंग and next user secondary clarifier or smaller plant, maybe say it's a tube settler. So this aerobic and tube settler, it means you are providing two and three tanks in the conventional sewage treatment plant, whereas if you see this flowchart, there's a one only tank is provided, which is your aerobic tank and with the MBR tank. Here I will tell you one more thing. If you are designing a very smaller capacity of the sewage treatment plant, let's say 50 or 75 KLD plant, if you do not bifurcate MBR tank and aeration tank, that's completely okay. But if you are designing a larger capacity of the sewage treatment plant, let's say 0.5 MLD or 1 MLD, 2 MLD, 5 MLD, you will have to design a two separate tank. One is your aeration tank, another is your MBR tank. But there is no slush separation with the gravity thing is happening. So you can avoid in the smaller capacity plant. The fourth is, what is the membrane? This is a very important thing which we need to understand. Sometimes we get confused between two things, that we can get class one, class A water quality by using membranes. But membrane is a just physical barrier. Membrane do not contribute to your biological process or biological activity. For example, we are getting certain kind of BOD and COD in the wastewater treatment plant, and you are trying to bring down to the, let's say, level of 20, 10 or 5. So, aapko aeration system aur aapke biological process is tarah se design karna padega so that complete BOD COD get digest. Membranes are just a physical barrier, like you are putting some kind of barrier in the aeration tank. और वहां से आप स्लज को सेपरेट कर रहे हैं, वाटर को सेपरेट कर रहे हैं. तो इट्स जस्ट फिजिकल बैरियर, इट डू नॉट रिड्यूस और इट डू नॉट कंट्रीब्यूट इन योर बायोलॉजिकल प्रोसेस. समटाइम वी गेट कंफ्यूज कि एमबीआर लगाने से मुझे 5 ब्यूटी मिलेगा, बट नो, इट इज नॉट ट्रू. यू हैव टू फोकस ऑन योर प्री ट्रीटमेंट स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम योर स्क्रीनिंग टू एडिशन टाइम, देन एंड ओनली एमबीआर विल प्रोवाइड यू द गुड रिजल्ट. सो इफ यू सी दिस स्ट्रक्चर, लाइक these vertical things are your MBR. It could be a various material of construction, a various type, which we'll discuss in the next slide. These are the air bubble provided, which is required to clean the surface of the MBR. Brown color mein jo aapko dikha hai, this is your activated sludge, aur ye effluent, yahan se aapka treated water will come outside. So guys, I am getting frequent questions, but I request you to type and keep all the questions for the Q&A session, because if you start putting question right now, so I think I would not be able to reply you in detail. So these are the physical barriers.
Vinod, carry on with your presentation. We'll have a question answer later on in between.
Sure, Mirish bhai. Thank you so much. So if you say this is a physical barrier, bottom can the aeration system provide karna padta, because membranes require frequent cleaning of the surface. So ek taraf suction ho raha hai, ek taraf waste water ho raha hai, bottom mein aapka aeration ke through ye cleaning ho raha hai. So it is just a physical barrier. Now history of the MBR, we know that every technology takes some time to get commercialized. So before commercialized, there are lots of innovation is required. काफी R&D चाहिए, काफी जगह आपको manufacturing करके आपको trials लेने पड़ते हैं. Similar way, so I think the first submerged MBR were developed commercially by the Dor Oliver in 1960. So जहाँ पर आप देखें कि it's a submerged MBR. So specifically, I have written down submerged MBR. Later on, we will discuss what is the submerged and what is the side stream MBR. Third line, if you read, it's a combining ultrafiltration with the conventional activated sludge process by Bailey Berbisi. So when we say combined ultrafiltration, guys, membrane bioreactor is a part of ultrafiltration. Sometimes we get confused ki ultrafiltration alag ho gaya aur membrane bioreactor alag ho. No, ultrafiltration is a pore size. When you are selecting any kind of membrane, whether it is a submerged, which is shown in this process flow diagram, it is a submerged. submerged ultrafiltration or submerged microfiltration भी हो सकता है. तो remember the ultrafiltration is a pore size. अगर आप 0.1 micron का NBR या external NBR और external ultrafiltration या microfiltration select करें, so 0.1 is your microfiltration. Less than 0.1 it is a ultrafiltration. So principle of NBR as we know that slide पे मैंने काफी कुछ लिखा है, but the simple it is a physical barrier. If you are providing the aeration, aeration can the you are doing certain kind of biological activity, you are developing the MLSs at the higher level, which could be around minimum 6,000 and it can go up to 10,000 or 12,000 MLSs. Or usi aeration tank ke baad you provide a separate chamber and MBR work as a physical barrier. Jaise hum log typically aajkal kya hota hai ki we provide the MBBR or SBR system. After MBBR or SBR, we install an external ultrafiltration plant for the recycling application. So most of the industries may hota hai ki we provide two kind of treatment. One is your sewage treatment plant. Usme se 10 or 20% water you want to recycle, so you will be passing through that wastewater to the ultrafiltration and we are recycling back. But in MBR case, it is a 100% ultrafiltration process or microfiltration process. So whatever water is coming out from your wastewater, that would be A-class water, and MBR act as a physical barrier. Again, I'm emphasizing on this point. So there are two kind of MBR process. One is your side stream, another is a submerge. So if we talk about the ultrafiltration, the microfiltration, so based on this pore size, you identify ki aapka MBR किस पोर साइज का है. अगर वो 0.1 माइक्रोन का इट इज अ माइक्रोफिल्ट्रेशन. अगर 0.1 से नीचे लेट्स से 0.04 माइक्रोन, देयर आर लॉट्स ऑफ मैन्युफैक्चरर इन इंडिया हु प्रोड्यूस अल्ट्रा फिल्ट्रेशन MBR. वन इज द पोर साइज. अदर सिलेक्शन क्राइटेरिया ऑफ द एमबीआर इज क्या मुझे मेम्ब्रेन को सबमर्ज करना है या मैं एमबीआर मेम्ब्रेन को अलग से भी लगा सकता हूँ. तो फॉर एग्जाम्पल यू आर हैविंग सम काइंड ऑफ एग्जिस्टिंग conventional sewage treatment plant and you want to convert your conventional sewage treatment plant into the MBR application. So agar aap aeration tank mein hi ek pump laga ke agar aap external MBR laga de, which is known as a side stream MBR, you can do that. If you want to put submerged MBR inside the aeration tank, that's all possible. Selection we have to decide. So like worldwide the leading manufacturer of your side stream MBRs are Norit Panta. They provide different kind of capillary based side stream MBR jo aapko bahar lagate hain. Submerged ultra filtration mein there are many manufacturers, like if you start searching on a Google you will get lots of an n number of manufacturers of the submerged MBR. So these are the two differentiation and bifurcation of the MBR based on the installation, side stream and submerged. Now we will talk about the submerged MBR. Submerged MBR ke andar bhi you will see there are two kind of MBRs are available in the market. Now this is based on the construction. To pehla criteria ye hai ki aapka pore size kya hoga, uske base pe you decide ki whether it is a microfiltration or ultrafiltration, number 1. Number 2, are you going to select a side stream MBR or submerged MBR. The third criteria or third type of the within this group, कि अगर आपका सम्बर्ज एमबीआर है, अगेन देयर आर टू एमबीआर, वन इज योर हॉलो फाइबर एंड अनदर इज अ फ्लैट शीट. तो आपको नाम से मालूम पड़ेगा इट मींस हॉलो फाइबर्स. तो इफ यू सी दिस इमेज, इस इमेज के अंदर आपको ये वर्टिकल शीट्स दिख रही हैं या वर्टिकल कैसेट्स दिख रही है और इस कैसेट्स के अंदर मिलियंस ऑफ फाइबर्स होते हैं. तो दीज आर द फाइबर्स एंड दे आर हॉलो इनसाइड. तो दैट्स व्हाई आपको नाम से मालूम पड़ जाएगा कि इट्स अ हॉलो फाइबर, मतलब अ फाइबर विच इज हॉलो फ्रॉम द इनसाइड. और इनका डायमीटर वेरी करता है, लाइक फ्यू मैन्युफैक्चर स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम 0.6 mm टू इट गोज अराउंड 1.2 mm और 1.5 mm. तो इस फाइबर के सर्टेन डिमेंशंस होते हैं. फ्लैट शीट इट मींस कि देयर इज नो फाइबर, इट्स जस्ट अ स्ट्रेट शीट जो आप एक फ्रेम के अंदर लगा रहे हैं. तो दीज आर द फ्लैट शीट एमबीआर एंड हॉलो फाइबर. फिल्ट्रेशन के हम लोग बात करें तो दोनों ही केस के अंदर आउट टू इन फिल्ट्रेशन होगा. आउट टू इन फिल्ट्रेशन का मतलब ये होता है कि ये दोनों एमबीआर, वेदर इट्स हॉलो फाइबर और फ्लैट शीट, व्हेन यू आर पुटिंग इनसाइड द एडिशन टैंक, तो जो भी स्लज आ रहा है उनके आसपास हो रहा है. Now sludge is like a technical term में हम उसे बोलते हैं कि mixed liquor suspended solid, मतलब उसके अंदर digested sludge भी है, solids भी और water भी है. तो आपको sludge और water को separate करना है. तो filtration कैसे होगा कि चूंकि इसके चारों ओर आपका waste water है या mixed liquor sludge है और आप इसी ऊपर pump लगा के gravity से water को separate कर देंगे. आप वेस्ट वाटर को एक पंपिंग के थ्रू या ग्रेविटी, आई रिक्वेस्ट, आई हैव यू टू ऑल, प्लीज डू नॉट अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ. सो लाइक दिस वेस्ट वाटर यहाँ पे सेपरेट हो रहा है. तो व्हेनेवर वेस्ट वाटर आपका आउटसाइड एमबीआर हो रहा है, बेब्रेंस हो रहा है, तो व्हेन वाटर इज फ्लोइंग फ्रॉम आउट टू इन, तो इट्स कॉल्ड आउट टू इन फिल्ट्रेशन. तो सारा स्लज आपका बाहर डिपॉजिट होगा, ओनली वेस्ट वाटर और ट्रीटेड वाटर और क्लियर वाटर विल कम आउट थ्रू दिस होलो फाइबर शीट्स एंड फ्रॉम दिस फ्लैट शीट मेम्ब्रेन्स. नाउ विच मेम्ब्रेन वी शुड सिलेक्ट, दिस इज ऑलवेज अ कंफ्यूजन और सम टाइम वी नीड टू इवैल्यूएट दैट विच मेम्ब्रेन इज बेटर और विच material of construction we should consider, or yeah, hollow fiber or flat sheet. So these are the few parameters which I have written down, which may be a primary selection criteria for the flat sheet versus hollow fiber. So when we talk about the hollow fiber membranes, so first line is your low flux, and flat sheet mein aap dekhenge right hand side pe is a high flux. So before I talk about the low and high, I share what is the flux. फ्लक्स मीन्स कि आप एक स्क्वायर मीटर एमबीआर से कितना पानी निकाल रहे हैं एक घंटे के अंदर. बड़ा सिंपल सा फॉर्मूला है. इसकी जो यूनिट होती है विच इज योर एलएमएच, आप सेकंड लाइन में देखेंगे मैंने लेफ्ट हैंड साइड पे हॉलो फाइबर के नीचे लिखा हुआ है. जनरली वी कंसिडर 15 LMH to 20 LMH एंड फ्लैट शीट के अंदर ऑन अ सेफर साइड 20 to 25 LMH. तो फर्स्ट थिंग इज योर एलएमएच, लीटर पर स्क्वायर मीटर पर आवर. आप एमबीआर के सरफेस एरिया से कितना लीटर पानी विथड्रॉ करना चाहते हैं, दैट इज नोन एज अ फ्लक्स. नाउ हॉलो फाइबर के अंदर दे आर इट्स अ फ्लडेड, नाउ दिस मार्केट इज गेटिंग फ्लड एंड यू विल सी लॉट्स ऑफ मैन्युफैक्चरर एंड सप्लायर फ्रॉम द यूरोपियन कंट्री, अमेरिकन कंट्रीज एंड चाइनीज कंपनीज. सो यू हैव टू बी वेरी चूजी अबाउट द सिलेक्शन ऑफ द हॉलो फाइबर मेम्ब्रेन, कि आपकी मेम्ब्रेन के डिजाइन कैसी है, क्या उनके पास आरएनडी सेटअप है, क्या मैन्युफैक्चर हैज डन सर्टेन काइंड ऑफ रिसर्च, वेदर दे हैव अ सर्टेन इंस्टॉलेशन एंड नॉट, बिकॉज फ्लक्स इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल. अगर आपने काफी लार्जर लेवल पे काफी आपने एग्रेसिव फ्लक्स डिजाइन कर लिया तो मेम्ब्रेन फ्रिक्वेंटली क्लॉग होगी. बट इन जनरल हॉलो फाइबर की कंपनी में फ्लैट शीट में अगर आप थोड़ा सा एग्रेसिव फ्लक्स लेकर एमबीआर के सर्फेस एरिया को कम कर सकते हैं, इट्स योर चॉइस, वी कैन डू दैट. Second is the less membrane mechanical stability and good membrane stability. Guys, whenever you design any device, so we talk about the its mechanical stability. When I say less membrane mechanical stability, means if you see the bottom picture of this slide, there are n number of fibers you can see. Now what happened? कि आपके जो fibers होते हैं, vertical fibers, ये top पर और bottom पे certain chemical solutions से bonded रहते हैं. और फ्लैट शीट के अंदर आप देखेंगे तो ये इंडिविजुअल शीट्स होती हैं, इनका बॉटम या टॉप पे कोई बॉन्डेशन नहीं होता है. तो अगर आप बॉन्डिंग कर रहे हैं, उस बॉन्डिंग के केमिकल अगर प्रॉपरली डिजाइन नहीं है, अगर मैन्युफैक्चरर का कोई प्रॉब्लम है, इफ मैन्युफैक्चरर इज नॉट ऑथेंटिक और दे डू नॉट हैव रिसर्च एंड डेवलपमेंट फैसिलिटी, जस्ट दे आर बाइंग फाइबर्स आपको फ्रेम पर लगाकर बेच रहे हैं, तो बी केयरफुल, क्योंकि उस कंडीशन में आपकी फाइबर्स की मैकेनिकल स्टेबिलिटी विल बी लोअर. व्हेन आई से मैकेनिकल स्टेबिलिटी, तो फॉर एग्जांपल आपने एमबीआर को एडिशन टैंक में डाल के या सेपरेट टैंक बना के आपने आपका वेस्ट वाटर शुरू किया. नाउ एमबीआर को क्लीन करने के लिए कंटिन्यूस बेसिस पे यू रिक्वायर सर्टन काइंड ऑफ एयर, वी कॉल इट एयर स्कोरिंग ऑफ द मेम्ब्रेन. तो जब बॉटम से आपका एयर चलता है तो कहीं ना कहीं वाइब्रेशंस भी होते हैं, कहीं ना कहीं स्लज का डिपोजिशन भी बॉटम पे हो रहा है, आपका मैकेनिकल सक्शन भी हो रहा है. तो उस कंडीशन में इफ योर फाइबर की स्ट्रेंथ, ये फाइबर को फ्रेम पे या कैसेट पे लगाने की स्ट्रेंथ अगर सफिशिएंट नहीं है तो फाइबर विल कम आउट. जैसे ही फाइबर आपके कम आउट आएंगे, योर आउटपुट क्वालिटी विल गेट डिस्टर्ब एंड यू विल नॉट गेट द डिजायर्ड वाटर क्वालिटी. Whereas फैट शीट के अंदर अगर हम लोग मैग्नेट मेम्ब्रेन मैकेनिकल स्टेबिलिटी की बात करते हैं तो इसमें कोई केमिकल नहीं हो रहा है, ये सर्टन आपने शीट्स लगा रखी हैं, तो इन दैट कंडीशन आपकी स्टेबिलिटी कंपेयर टू होलो फाइबर बेटर होती है. थर्ड थिंग इज अ लेस एयर रिक्वायरमेंट एंड हायर रिक्वायरमेंट. तो किसी भी मेम्ब्रेन को क्लीन करने के लिए आपको बॉटम में डिफ्यूजर्स लगाने पड़ेंगे, एडिशन ग्रीड बनानी पड़ेगी, और वो एडिशन ग्रीड आपके एक्सटर्नल एयर का जो भी सोर्स है, वेदर यू इंस्टॉल अ ब्लोवर और व्हाटएवर कंप्रेशर, वो आप लगा रहे हैं. नाउ चूंकि आपने होलो फाइबर्स को एक ही जगह पर बॉन्डिंग किया हुआ है, तो इन टर्म्स ऑफ डिमेंशन अगर आप देखेंगे, फॉर एग्जांपल यू सिलेक्ट कि मेरा 100 स्क्वायर मीटर का एमबीआर है, तो 100 स्क्वायर मीटर का डायमेंशन होलो फाइबर वर्सेस फ्लैट शीट, तो होलो फाइबर का डिमेंशन लेट से अगर 1 है तो फ्लैट शीट का डिमेंशन प्रोबेबली 1.5 होगा. इट मींस डिमेंशन ऑफ द फ्रेम एंड मेम्ब्रेन एरिया इज मोर इन फ्लैट शीट कंपेयर टू होलो फाइबर. नाउ चूंकि आपका एरिया एमबीआर का कम है, एमबीआर के डिमेंशन कम है, तो जो एयर की रिक्वायरमेंट होती है फाइबर्स को क्लीन करने के लिए, वो एयर डिमांड कम होता है. होलो फाइबर के अंदर, सॉरी फ्लैट शीट के अंदर आपका मेम्ब्रेन का डायमेंशन ज्यादा है क्योंकि आपने इसे शीट्स वर्टिकल लगाए. होप यू आर ट्राइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड. होलो फाइबर आपने एक जगह लगा लिया, आप इमेज पे देखना बॉटम साइड पे कि आपने एक ही जगह सारे फाइबर्स लगा दिए, और शीट्स के अंदर आपने एक एक करके शीट लगाया, तो उसका डायमेंशन ज्यादा है, इट रिक्वायर मोर एयर फॉर द क्लीनिंग पर्पस. फिफ्थ पॉइंट इज योर लाइफ ऑफ द एमबीआर. लाइफ ऑफ द एमबीआर इज स्लाइटली कॉन्ट्रोवर्शियल थिंग हो जाती कभी कभी, क्योंकि लाइफ ऑफ द एमबीआर इज कंप्लीटली डिपेंड अपॉन योर प्री ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ द वेस्ट वाटर ट्रीटमेंट प्लान. जहां से आपका वेस्ट वाटर एंटर हो रहा है फ्रॉम स्क्रीनिंग, ऑयल एंड ग्रीस कलेक्शन, एनॉक्सिक चैम्बर, एडिशन, देन फाइन स्क्रीनिंग प्रोसेस, अगर आपका बायोलॉजी प्रॉपरली डिजाइन नहीं है, योर एमबीआर विल नॉट परफॉर्म और विल नॉट रन एज पर योर एक्सपेक्टेशन. तो समटाइम वी हैव ऑब्जर्व्ड प्रैक्टिकली कि हम लोगों ने काफी इंटरनेशनल लेवल के एमबीआर के प्लांट देखे हैं, बट वहां पे कहीं ना कहीं अगर प्राइमरी लेवल पर डिजाइन फॉल्ट हो जाता है तो मेम्ब्रेन स्टार्ट गेटिंग फ्रिक्वेंटली, वो चोक होता रहता है. अब चोकिंग हो रहा तो आप उसको फ्रिक्वेंटली क्लीन करना शुरू करेंगे, और आप जितना क्लीन करेंगे समटाइम उसकी लाइफ इंपैक्ट कर सकती है. देन हम लोग फ्लक्स की बात करते हैं. फ्लक्स भी इस चीज पर डिपेंड कर रहा है कि आपकी बायोलॉजिकल प्रोसेस आपने कैसे डिजाइन किया हुआ है. तो लाइफ ऑफ द एमबीआर इज सब्जेक्टेड टू योर प्राइमरी ट्रीटमेंट एंड बायोलॉजिकल डिजाइनिंग, एंड whoever is a supplier or manufacturer of the MBR, they have certain guidelines and parameter ki if you follow this parameter, then only you will get the performance guarantee and warranty of the MBR. agar aapne unki guideline ke hisab se ek bhi instrument wastewater treatment plant mein nahi lagaya, so there are chances that you will not get the replacement or some kind of pro rata warranty and guarantee from the manufacturer. During the replacement, hard to find damaged fiber. During the replacement, easy to find damaged. So yeah, now guys, it's about the cleaning. Or आपने MBR को लगाया, एक साल, डेढ़ साल, दो साल तक आपका plant चल रहा है, but एक certain time के बाद you have to clean your MBR or membrane physically sometime. So sometimes you have to take out the MBR from the aeration tank and you need to clean by the jetting machines. और आप उसको केमिकल से क्लीन करते हैं, विच इज नोन एज ए केमिकल इनक्रेस और केमिकल एनहांस बैकवॉशिंग के थ्रू. तो समटाइम अगर आपका प्लांट ऑपरेशन में है और आपके फाइबर्स डैमेज हो गए, सो यू विल नॉट बी एबल टू आइडेंटिफाई कि मेरे आउटलेट वाटर क्वालिटी अगर डिस्टर्ब हो रही है तो मेरे होलो फाइबर के अंदर कितने फाइबर डैमेज हो चुके हैं, या जितने फाइबर मेरे बॉटम में जो लगाए थे या टॉप पे जो लगाए वो कितने डैमेज हुए. तो स्लाइटली इट्स डिफिकल्ट. कैसेट्स के अंदर ये होता है कि कैसेट में भी वैसे आपको पता नहीं लगा कि कैसेट कब फट गया. कभी कभी शार्प एज लगती है तो ये फ्लैट शीट के जो कैसेट्स होते हैं, जो मेम्ब्रेन होती है, बीच में से टोन हो जाती है, तो यू विल नॉट बी एबल टू आइडेंटिफाई. यस, बट रिप्लेसमेंट ऑफ द शीट्स इज वेरी इजी. इफ यू वांट टू चेक योर फ्लैट शीट, इट इज पॉसिबल, यू कैन चेक इट वन बाय वन. सो दीज आर द अ फ्यू डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन फ्लैट एंड होलो फाइबर. These are the typical flowchart for the MBR-based sewage treatment plant. The first, we start from the bar screening. It is always require bar screening, irrespective of any technology, from anaerobic to aerobic, aerobic kind of conventional MBBR, MBR, SBR, whatever technology you're using, RBC or whatever, you certainly require certain kind of screening system to avoid coming, you are suspended or big particles inside the system. Is diagram we have not shown the oil and grease chamber, but yes, it is mandatory. Specifically, if you have MBR place sewage treatment plant design, and more importantly, if you have hotel industry design, oil and grease trap with the proper removal system, it is mandatory because MBR is very, very sensitive for the oil. अगर ऑयल का लेयर आपके एमबीआर की शीट या फाइबर के ऊपर डिपॉजिट हो जाता है, देयर आर चांसेस इट विल गेट क्लॉक वेरी फ्रीक्वेंटली. सो योर स्क्रीनिंग सिस्टम, ऑयल एंड ग्रीस सिस्टम हैज टू बी डिजाइंड वेरी प्रॉपरली. नेक्स्ट इज द कलेक्शन टैंक. यू ऑल आर अवेयर, यू ऑल आर, यू बिलोंग्स टू दिस मार्केट. कलेक्शन टैंक इज मैंडेटरी टू हैंडल द पिक फ्लो व्हिच इज कमिंग आउट फ्रॉम योर सोसाइटी और फ्रॉम योर प्रीमाइसेस. सो कलेक्शन टैंक डायमेंशन varies from 6 to 12 hours, depend upon the designing level, how you design your plant. But collection tank is mandatory and it is a part of MBR process also. From collection tank, it goes to the aeration tank. Aeration tank, usually standard job design, but what is the difference of aeration tank with MBR technology and with the general technology? So let's talk about the core basic technology हम लोग जो यूज कर रहे हैं. कन्वेंशनल टेक्नोलॉजी की बात करें, कन्वेंशनल एक्टिवेटेड स्लज प्रोसेस जो हम लोग एसटीपी लगा रहे हैं, तो उसके अंदर एडिशन टैंक का डिमेंशन यूजली डिपेंड अपॉन योर एफएम रेशियो और एमालिसिस के हिसाब से कुड वेरी फ्रॉम 14 टू 24 आवर और 28 आवर, डिपेंड कि इनलेट का ब्यूरी सीयूरी कितना आ रहा है. आई टेक एग्जाम्पल, इट्स अ डोमेस्टिक सीवेज वेयर 300 टू 400 ब्यूरी इज कमिंग. इन कन्वेंशनल sewage treatment plant, your aeration tank size may vary from 16 to 22 hours, for example. If you are selecting MBBR technology, moving bed bioreactor or attached biogrowth technology, your aeration tank volume would be around 6 to 8 hours, probably. If you are selecting SBR boost, sequential batch reactor plant, then depend upon the design, it varies from 10 to 16 hours or 18 hours. If you design MBR based sewage treatment plant, thumb rule, I'm just sharing thumb rule with you, but there are certain ranges and limitations are available in the detailed technical sheet. If you people need a detailed calculation sheet of the aeration tank with the various technology, you can mail me, I would share with all of you. So when we design MBR based aeration tank, since MBR require more MLSS like 4,000, 6,000, sometimes 8,000 or 10,000. So since you are running your activated sludge process with the very high MLSS, or high MLSS per aapke aeration tank ki sizes reduce ho jati hai. Roughly, agar aap 7 to 9 hours or 7 to 10 hours ka aeration tank in domestic sewage treatment plant ke andar design karte hain, so that is a comfortable size for the MBR. Again, I am telling you that depend upon your inlet parameter, your air demand, your FIM ratio, your MLSS selection process, which I can share with all of you if required. Aeration tank ke baad, the mixed liquor suspended solid goes to the MBR tank. But here you have to provide one micro automatic screen. किसी भी MBR की एक limitation होती है कि जब आपका waste water हमारे MBR tank के अंदर आ रहा है, लेस देन 3 mm का ऑटोमेटिक स्क्रीनिंग इज कंपल्सरी. अगर आपने इनलेट पर 30, 20 या 10 या 6 mm की आप स्क्रीनिंग लगा रहे हैं, दो स्क्रीनिंग आर ओके फॉर योर बायोलॉजिकल प्रोसेस. बट इफ यूर वेस्ट वाटर गेटिंग इन टू द MBR टैंक, अगर आपने सेपरेटली बनाया, यू विल हैव टू इंस्टॉल वन ऑटोमेटिक क्लीनिंग वाला स्क्रीन, प्रिफरेबली जो ड्रम टाइप के स्क्रीन आते हैं, और ड्रम टाइप स्क्रीन में भी देयर इज अ पंच होल स्क्रीन. यू कैन नोट डाउन, इट्स अ पंच होल स्क्रीन इज द बेस्ट स्क्रीन फॉर एनी एमबीआर सिस्टम. द होल साइज हैज टू बी लेस देन 3 mm. और अगर आप 3 mm का स्क्रीन डिजाइन कर रहे हैं, तो डेफिनेटली मैनुअल क्लीन करना उससे डिफिकल्ट हो जाता है. तो 3 mm के स्क्रीनिंग में यू हैव टू गो फॉर द ऑटोमेटिक क्लीनिंग ऑफ द सिस्टम. तो आपको फ्रिक्वेंट क्लीनिंग, जब एमबीआर चोक हो रहा है, तो उसको आपको रेगुलरली क्लीन करने की जरूरत नहीं है. एंड आफ्टर एमडीआर दिस ब्लू लाइन यू कैन से इट इज अ सक्शन पंप एंड ट्रीटेड वाटर यू कैन गेट इनटू द ट्रीटेड वाटर टैंक. सो देयर इज नो ट्यूब सेटलर, नो क्लेरिफायर, नो सैंड फिल्टर, नो कार्बन फिल्टर. जस्ट यू हैव टू प्रोवाइड एडिशन टैंक, एमडीआर टैंक, एंड द आउटलेट ऑफ वाटर गोज टू द ट्रीटेड वाटर टैंक वेयर यू कैन डेफिनेटली गेट लेस देन 5 BOD, 30 COD. Turbidity and TSS depend. आपने माइक्रो फिल्ट्रेशन एमडीआर लिया है या अल्ट्रा फिल्ट्रेशन एमडीआर. If you are selecting ultra filtration MDR, then definitely your TSS and turbidity would be less than 1. And if you are feeding this water directly into the industries, like when you are designing a zero liquid discharge plant for your industrial application and you are going to recycle treated wastewater through the RO plant, you certainly require less than 3 SDI for the RO membrane. So, agar aapka zero liquid discharge hai, certainly you require a less than 3 SDI, which you can get by installing ultra filtration MDR. So this is a general flow chart. I have written down point number 3, anoxic tank. So anoxic tank, ideally it is optional, but if you are designing a larger capacity of the sewage treatment plant, like I share one example with you. Now, Ahmedabad Municipal Corporation is floating around 15 to 16 tender of the sewage treatment plant. And all the tenders are based on MDR technology. Okay, certain criteria decided ki Ahmedabad mein jitne bhi decentralized sewage treatment plant lagayenge, Ahmedabad Municipal Corporation ki definition mein decentralized plant ki capacity means ranging from 0.3 MLD to 7 MLD. So alag alag location pe within the Ahmedabad they are going to install a decentralized sewage treatment plant, and those sewage treatment plant shall be based on the MDR technology. Aur usme they are not just asking for the reduction of BOD and COD. They are also asking for the bio-nutrient removal, which is known as a BNR. So agar aapko total nitrogen bhi reduce karna hai, the anoxic process is compulsory, whatever technology you select. MDR ke case mein bhi before addition tank you will have to go for the anoxic tank for the reduction of the total nitrogen in BNR process. So slightly we'll go through the detailed process. Bar screening chamber, which is a part of the any sewage treatment plant, we know that we want to reduce a segregated plastic, napkins and floating object which is coming along with your wastewater from the any application. We require a bar screening chamber that depend upon the, it could be 30 mm, 20 mm, 10 mm. Depend karta hai ki aap kis application ke liye select kar rahe hain. For the municipal level, normally they go for the two stage screening system. The first screening is around 40 mm, then second stage it is around 20, then 10 and then 6. Agar aap residential mein design kare to I would be comfortable with the 20 and 10 mm screening. That's perfectly okay. Here again I have missed to add a oil and grease chamber, but after bar screening chamber certainly you require oil and grease tap for the reduction and removal of your oil, fat and grease. Equalization tank, we all know that any process require equalization tank. The volume can vary minimum from 6 hours to 12 hours. Again, for which industry or which application you are designing your sewage treatment plant, you have to calculate what is the peak flow, what is their consumption pattern, inflow ka and what is the outflow ka consumption pattern. So based on this parameter, you have to design your equalization tank. Ideal comfortable size for the equalization is 6 to 12 hours. Sometimes municipal corporation can the you don't require equalization tank. In municipal sewage treatment plant, they already design a large pumping station. Or pumping station ka directly jo inlet hota hai, that goes to the inlet chamber and grid chamber of the centralized sewage treatment plant. So in case of centralized sewage treatment plant designed for the municipal corporation, you may not require equalization tank. But in that condition, you have to design your sewage treatment plant with the peak flow, which could be 2.5, 3 or 3.5. Anoxic tank, which I shared with you, it is a compulsory now. If you are looking for a BNR process, which is your bio-nutrient removal process, and you are trying to reduce your total nitrogen, anoxic tank, like thumb rule, होता है वैसे डिटेल कैलकुलेशन. अगेन आई एम शेयरिंग विद यू, इफ यू रिक्वायर डिटेल कैलकुलेशन आई वुड शेयर विद यू. एनॉक्सिक टैंक यूजली डोमेस्टिक सीवेज ट्रीटमेंट प्लांट के अंदर हम लोग डिजाइन करें तो 2 से 2.5 घंटा या 3 घंटे का अगर आप टैंक डिजाइन करें एनॉक्सिक प्रोसेस के लिए विद द स्लो स्पीड मिक्सचर, सो दैट इज सफिशियंट फॉर द डोमेस्टिक sewage treatment plant. For the industrial application, we have to calculate. But ideal tank, 2 to 3 hour, with this slow speed mixture, you are done. Third is definitely aeration tank. I think we all are familiar with the aeration tank. But in MBR, you have to consider minimum 4 to 5,000 MLSS while designing of the aeration tank. And aeration, the device, a mechanical device, you can choose. You can go for the air root blower. You can go for the turbo blower. Nowadays, there is an energy efficient surface aerator and bottom aerators are available. So it's your choice what kind of aeration device you are looking for to provide sufficient oxygen to the aeration tank. But the dimension of the aeration tank must be designed with the higher MLSS of 4,000 to 8,000. That will give you the right dimension of the aeration tank. The fifth tank is your MBR. So like MBR, again, I insist, it's a physical barrier. It's kind of physical separation. Now, your separation and quality of the water or life of the MBS always depend upon your MLSS. Jitna achha aapka MLSS aeration tank ka the develop hoga, utna efficient filtration system is going to work. If you are going to run your STP with the very low MLSS, and definitely it is one of the problem, like when we start sewage treatment plant or any wastewater treatment plant, we are not getting sufficient or desired inlet BOD and COD, and it sometimes it takes time to cultivate the bacteria. So during that process, I would recommend do not start your MBR if your MLSS is around 1000 or 1500 milligram. I would prefer to start my MBR with the 4,000 to 5,000 MLSS. And after your MBR is going to work fantastically. Why 4 to 5,000 MLSS? Because jitna dense or jitna separated aapka MLSS hoga, utni filtration efficiency badhegi. Agar MLSS low hai, aapne filtration karna shuru kiya, aapne ya MBR se pump ke through water ko suck kiya, to there are chances ki aapka jo undigested sludge hai ya kuch bacteria hai, those bacteria may form a slimy layer on your sheet or fiber, and it will lead to the transmembrane pressure. Har ek membrane ka ek pressure hota hai, to us differential pressure ko increase karega, and your system will be in a chemical state. So avoid to operate your MBR if your MLSS is a lower. Now, how to design this MBR? This slide is very much important. I think if someone wants to click this slide, you can do that. These are the basic parameters which I have considered for the selection of the MBR. First thing you have to see whether it is a residential, commercial, hospitality, industrial, or municipal corporation. So based on your wastewater, you have to decide what kind of wastewater is coming into your ETP or zero liquid discharge or your sewage treatment plant. Second, I personally recommend we should design MBR based plant with the 20-hour operation. Why I tell you in detail? So like 500 meter cube per day ka sewage treatment plant design kar rahe hain, aur 20-hour operation hai. So a normal flow rate would be 25,000 liter per hour. Third thing is your flux rate. So why flux rate? Because you have flow rate aa gaya. Now the third part is that yaar kitne square meter ka mujhe MBR lagana hai. So aapne flow identify kar liya hai, fir aap kisi manufacturer se baat karte hain, you and your team technically get trained with the MBR supplier, and MBR supplier says ki sir aapka ye jo wastewater quality hai iske upar recommended flux ye hona chahiye. So for example, again I tell, flux rate means LMH एक स्क्वायर मीटर एमबीआर से इतना लीटर पानी हमें निकालना है. तो लेट्स से फ्लक्स रेंज मोस्ट ऑफ द मैन्युफैक्चरर रिकमेंड बिटवीन 10 टू 25 एलएमएच. वर्स्ट वाटर क्वालिटी, अ वर्स्ट एफ्लुएंट, यू शुड ऑलवेज गो विद द लो फ्लक्स. लाइक वी हैव डन सम प्रोजेक्ट विद द फूड इंडस्ट्री इज ऑलवेज विद द हायर ब्यूटी स्यूडी. सो या डेफिनेटली यू ऑल नीड टू गो फॉर द एनएरोबिक एंड एरोबिक प्रोसेस विद द कॉम्बिनेशन. So whenever you are handling critical wastewater of the industries, it could be a pharmaceutical, textile, power plant, sugar, or food and beverages, you should go for the lower flux range and with the recommendation of your manufacturer. the highest flux, I would suggest you should not cross 25 LMH. Mm-hmm. 25 LMH is a very aggressive. Iske upar aap jaye to you are not sure ki aapka MVR kitne time mein kharab ho jayega ya kitne time mein uske cleaning frequency aayegi. So it is a most aggressive range. अगर आप बहुत सेफ्टी फैक्टर के हिसाब से आपकी बायोलॉजी डिजाइन कर रहे हैं, यू आर एश्योर अबाउट द इनडेट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक लाइक डोमेस्टिक सीवेज ट्रीटमेंट प्लांट के अंदर यूजली वेरिएशन नहीं होता है, तो यू आर श्योर अबाउट योर इनडेट वेस्ट वाटर क्वालिटी, योर बायोलॉजी इज डिजाइन प्रॉपरली, यू हैव प्रोवाइडेड टू और थ्री स्टेज ऑफ स्क्रीनिंग सिस्टम, यू कैन टेक अ चांस टू रन योर सीवेज ट्रीटमेंट प्लांट विद द हायर एक्यूरेसी, नो डाउट अबाउट दैट. नाउ हाउ टू कैलकुलेट द सरफेस एरिया. से 25,000 लीटर इज योर फ्लो रेट, आपने एक मीड वैल्यू लेके 20 से डिवाइड किया, तो 1250 स्क्वायर मीटर इज योर एरिया ऑफ द एमबीआर. फोर्थ पार्ट इज द व्हाट इज द पोर साइज, वेदर आई शुड सेलेक्ट अ माइक्रो और अल्ट्रा फिल्ट्रेशन, लाइक 0.1 माइक्रोन का मैं एमबीआर सेलेक्ट करूं या 0.04 या 0.05 एमबीआर सेलेक्ट करूं. इसमें यह है कि अगर आप वाटर को रिसाइकल कर रहे हैं ओनली फॉर द टॉयलेट फ्लशिंग एप्लीकेशन या आप एच वी या कूलिंग टॉवर में रिसाइकल करें, तो इवन दो इफ यू सिलेक्ट माइक्रो फिल्ट्रेशन और अल्ट्रा फिल्ट्रेशन डजंट मेक मच डिफरेंस, क्योंकि 0.1 माइक्रोन और 0.05 माइक्रोन ये दो पोर साइज आप बात कर रहे हैं. आई वुड पर्सनली रिकमेंड इफ वी आर पुटिंग एमबीआर ट्रीटेड वाटर इन टू आर ओ प्लांट, यू मस्ट गो फॉर द अल्ट्रा फिल्ट्रेशन बेस्ड एमबीआर. रीजन, RO membrane की भी certain limitation है. RO membrane manufacturer always demand less than 3 SDI. And if you are looking for a 3 SDI, ultra filtration MBR will be always better compared to microfiltration. But if your object is not fitting into the RO plant, you are just recycling your water or reusing in certain application, perfectly microfiltration, we can move on. Material of construction, now various kind of material of construction available in the market. It is a PVDF, polypropylene, polyethylene, and nowadays ceramic membranes are going to be very popular in India. They have recently launched in India with some German company or by some Danish company. I will tell you about the ceramic also. So PVDF is more reliable if you are selecting hollow fiber or flat sheet MBR. We were talking about the life of the MBR. So PVDF always run. Like I have seen one MBR plant which has been installed by some company in 2007. And I think their first replacement was in 2018. It means the MBR could run 11 years. So it was surprising for all of us ki hum logon ne commitment 5 saal kiya tha, but 11 saal tak wo MBR consistently performed kiya uske. The material of construction was PVDF, biologically काफी अच्छे से डिजाइन किया था. Secondly, polypropylene. So it is like a comparing gold and silver. अगर 40,000 रुपए में आपको एक तोला गोल्ड मिल रहा है तो 35,000 या 40,000 में आपको एक किलो चांदी मिल रही है, तो ये फर्क हो गया. Polypropylene based अगर आप MBR select कर रहे हैं, there are 100% chances that your MBR is going to clog in next 1.5 year or 2 year. 1.5 से 2 साल में आप MBR बदलने की तैयारी कर लीजिए अगर आप PP या PE मटेरियल यूज कर रहे हैं. Where people use polypropylene and polyethylene. Number one, for example, 1250 स्क्वायर मीटर का आपको MBR परचेज करना है, and I say roughly cost of 1250 स्क्वायर मीटर से 12.5 लाख रुपीस, for example, with the PVDF material or micro or ultra filtration or hollow fiber, flat sheet, whatever. If you go for the polypropylene material, you will get this membrane. I bet you 12.5 lakh se wo cost reduce hoke 3 se 4 lakh par aa jayega. So it means aapne kareeban 60% aapki capital cost ko reduce kar diya hai by using PP membrane. So agar mera 1 crore ka plant design kar raha hu, usme andar maine 12 lakh ka MBR lagaya hai, uski cost mein reduce hoke shayad se 3.5-4 lakh pad jati hai. Now your user is okay with that. You know, मैं मुझे 12 लाख का एक MBR नहीं लगाना, मैं 4 लाख का एक MBR लगा के हर साल बदलूंगा. We have उसकी चॉइस रहती है. Either it is not technically recommended, but मैं commercial point of view से बात कर रहा हूँ जो market में आप सभी face करते होंगे. तो polypropylene is the cheapest option with the lowest capital cost. और अगर builder या बाद में बदलना चाहे तो ये उसका choice है. But इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द लाइफ साइकिल कॉस्ट, एलसीसी की बात करें कि 10 ईयर डाउन द लाइन मेरा एनर्जी कंजम्पशन कितना है, मेंटेनेंस कितना आ रहा है, मेंबरेन की रिप्लेसमेंट फ्रीक्वेंसी कितनी आ रही है. तो इफ योर ऑब्जेक्ट इज लाइफ साइकिल कॉस्ट फॉर द 10 ईयर, TVDF इज द बेस्ट. इफ यू आर कैलकुलेटिंग शॉर्ट लाइफ 1 year, 2 year, you may try for the polypropylene. Ceramics are now in trend. Commonly, ceramics are used into the oil and refineries. Companies like IOCL, ONGC, Reliance, they are using ceramic MBRs and ceramic membranes for the oil separation also. Now, if you talk about the ceramic MBR, the advantage of ceramic MBR is that they claim their flux rate can be around 6 times higher than normal PVDF membrane. So for example, 25,000 liter ka jo upar hum log ne plant design kiya with the 20 LMH and we are getting 1250 square meter area. If you use ceramic membrane, this area will go down to 200 square meter. Matlab 1250 se reduce hoke 200 square meter par aapka MBR ka size aa sakta hai. So ceramic is a very high flux MBR, but the capital cost is also around 7 to 8 times higher than PVDF. So agar 12.5 lakh mein agar aap yahan par PVDF purchase kare, figures mein roughly bol raha hu, I am not giving any commercial idea. So ceramic ke chances it could be around 25 to 27 lakh rupees. But the life of the ceramic is definitely more than 10 years. It works on a very high flux, so it reduces your overall tank dimension and area of the plant. It is also energy efficient because it requires less air to clean the surface of the MBR. So I think next market after 2 years, 3 years, you can see lots of ceramic MBR is about to come in the market. Type of MBR we have already discussed is hollow fiber and flat sheet, but I am talking about the submerged. You said it's a side steel. It could be spiral wood or a tubular kind of MBR. Air scoring demand. Air, कितना एयर लगेगा? तो एक स्क्वायर मीटर एमबीआर को क्लीन करने के लिए यू रिक्वायर सर्टेन एरिया. माय ऑब्जर्वेशन से, माय कैलकुलेशन से, इफ यू आर यूजिंग होलो फाइबर एमबीआर, यू रिक्वायर 0.3 m³ पर आवर पर स्क्वायर मीटर. इट्स योर एयर डिमांड फॉर द होलो फाइबर प्रिसाइजली. एंड इफ यू आर यूजिंग फ्लैट शीट एमबीआर, देन योर एयर डिमांड इज अराउंड 0.7 m³ per hour per square meter. So flat sheet definitely need more air demand for the air scoring. So uske blower ke design aur aeration equipment ke design definitely zyada hogi. So it is known as a ki jab bhi aap, so whenever you compare, you will find with the flat sheet MBR there will be a slightly higher energy consumption compared to hollow fiber. CIP and CED, chemical in process or chemical enhanced backwashing. Ideally, there are two kind of cleaning system is adopted into the MBR plant. So MBR, जैसे we were talking कि हमें selection हमेशा 20 hour operation में करना चाहिए. Why 20 hour operation? So MBR के अंदर this is cycle system कि आपको 8 minute तक MBR से water को suck करना है और 2 मिनट के लिए आपको सक्शन पंप बंद कर देना है. सो 8 मिनट सक्शन एंड 2 मिनट ऑफ. तो पंप का ऑन एंड ऑफ आपने जो सिखाया, तो वन साइकिल इज योर 8 times 2, 8 मिनट आपका सक्शन हो रहा है, 2 मिनट के लिए आपने पंप को बंद किया है. जब आप पंप को बंद करते हैं तो उसकी जो सरफेस क्लीनिंग है एयर का और मेम्ब्रेन का वो ज्यादा इफिशियंट होता है. So MBR is always designed on a cycle ratio. It could be 7-minute, 2-minute cycle. It could be 8-minute, 10-minute. Depend aap kaise design kar rahe. But most preferred cycle is 8x2. So for example, 1 ghante ke andar aapne 5 cycle decide ki. Ki 8, 5, 40, 40 minute aapka suction hua aur 10 to 12 minute aapne usko cleaning kiya. Now this is your filtration cycle. Now filtration cycle, एक number of filtration cycle होने के बाद, for example आपने 50 filtration cycle ले ली है, उसके बाद आपको chemical cleaning करना पड़ता है, और एक certain chemical cleaning के बाद आपका chemical enhanced backwashing होता है, which is normally 3 महीने में एक बार आता है. तो आप कह सकते हैं कि week में एक बार आपका chemical cleaning हुआ, और second जो major chemical cleaning आएगा वो आपका 3 months में आएगा. एंड एक साल में देयर आर चांसेस कि आपको फिजिकल क्लीनिंग भी एमबीआर का करना पड़ सकता है विद द जेट मशीन, डिपेंड हाउ योर बायोलॉजी इज परफॉर्मिंग. सो दीज आर द पॉइंट यू नीड टू टेक केयर व्हेन यू आर डिजाइनिंग योर एमबीआर. एडवांटेज ऑफ एमबीआर, वी नो दैट पहला स्लाइड में जो था कि व्हाई एमबीआर, दैट बिकम्स अ एडवांटेज ऑफ द एमबीआर. If you are genuinely looking for class A water quality, when I say class A water quality, आपकी genuine demand है कि मुझे less than 5 BOD, 30 COD चाहिए, turbidity 1 चाहिए, TEC 1 चाहिए, number one criteria, definitely MBR is for you. MBR can deliver consistently high permit quality for discharge and reuse. No impact from feed water, that is not Yeah, I did, Mireshwai, thank you. So if you are not feed water fluctuation, sometime आपकी water quality में थोड़ा बहुत variation आने के chances होता है. अगर आप high MLSS से plant design करें तो MBR, तो अगर आपका slightly 10-12% BOD COD में fluctuation आता है तो still MBR can manage some level, but अगेन बायोलॉजी में आपने कितना सेव किया हुआ है. और रिड्यूस योर लॉन्गर स्लज रिटेंशन टाइम सिंस एमबीआर इज वर्क विद द हाई एमएलएसएस मिक्स लीकर सस्पेंड सॉलिड 4,000, 5,000, 6,000 पे आप जान लगे, तो इट मींस जो स्लज का ड्रेन आउट होगा या वो काफी कम होगा, तो स्लज रिडक्शन भी हुआ वहां पे. प्लस लॉन्ग एसआरटी मींस डायमेंशन ऑफ द एरेशन टैंक विल आल्सो गो डाउन. एरेशन टैंक का जैसे ही आपका डायमेंशन कम होता है, सर्टेनली द टोटल फुटप्रिंट, टोटल एरिया विच इज रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द सीवेज ट्रीटमेंट प्लांट और एफ्लुएंट ट्रीटमेंट प्लांट, तो इट विल गो डाउन. बायोलॉजिकल रिमूवल ऑफ द अमोनिया बाय नाइट्रिफिकेशन प्रोसेस, सो इट इज नॉट ओनली फॉर द एमबीआर. व्हाटएवर वेस्ट वाटर ट्रीटमेंट प्लांट यू आर डिजाइनिंग, सर्टेनली यू हैव टू प्रोवाइड a dedicated tank and a mixture system for the reduction of your total ammonia and total nitrogen, which is part of your bio-neutral removal process, BNR process. No clarifier. This is very interesting point. I have seen many sewage treatment plants where sludge bulking is happening. So, for example, if your aeration tank is not performing well, या आपने प्लांट का डिजाइन 300 BUDP का और 700-800 BUDI का, डेफिनेटली एरेशन की डिमांड कम हो जाएगी, तो उतना इफिशिएंट एम्बुलेंसेस आप डेवलप नहीं कर पाओगे. तो समटाइम वी सी दैट स्लज इज बल्किंग ऑन द सरफेस ऑफ द एरेशन टैंक, वो एक स्लज का लेयर जम जाता है और वो स्लज का लेयर क्या होता है, वो कैरी फॉरवर्ड होता है. सो दैट स्लज गोज टू योर सेकेंडरी क्लेरिफायर और ट्यूब सेटलर समटाइम. नाउ वो स्लज मोस्ट ऑफ देम सेटल नहीं होता है, ट्यूब सेटलर या सेटलिंग टैंक या क्लेरिफायर देने के बाद भी आपका स्लज वो ऊपर ही तैर रहा है, इट इज अ फ्लोटिंग स्लज. नाउ वो फ्लोट स्लज क्या करता है कि वो कैरी करके नेक्स्ट आपके होल्डिंग टैंक या क्लोरिंग कॉन्टेक्ट टैंक में जाता है और वहां से पंप वो स्लज को फीड कर देता है सैंड फिल्टर और कार्बन फिल्टर में. एंड वी ऑल रिसीव सिमिलर काइंड ऑफ प्रॉब्लम कि साहब मेरा तो फिल्टर चुक हो गया या मेरा कार्बन चुक हो गया, सैंड फिल्टर चुक हो गया. जब आप उस फिल्टर को ओपन करके देखेंगे तो यू विल फाइंड लॉट्स ऑफ पार्टिकल्स और लॉट्स ऑफ डिपोजिशन ऑफ द कैरी ओवर स्लज. तो कैरी ओवर स्लज प्रॉब्लम हुआ आपके एरिशन टैंक में, वहां पे स्लज बल्किंग हुआ, वो स्लज बल्किंग ट्यूब सेटलर से क्लोरीन कॉन्टेक्ट टैंक से होते हुए सैंड फिल्टर कार्बन फिल्टर को उसे पूरा स्ट्रीम को चोक कर दिया. लोग प्लांट चलाते हैं तो 15-20 दिन के बाद सडनली यू विल रिसीव अ कॉल के साहब आपने जो 10 MQ पर आवर का फिल्टर दिया था इसमें से 3 MQ फ्लो निकल रहा है. इट्स अ वेरी प्रैक्टिकल प्रॉब्लम. एमबीआर के केस में थोड़ा एडवांटेज मिल जाता है, आपको रिलैक्सेशन मिल जाता है कि अगर स्लज बल्किंग भी हो रहा है एरिशन टैंक के अंदर, तो सिंस यू हैव प्रोवाइडेड अ फिजिकल बैरियर, तो आपका वो स्लज बल्किंग हुआ भी है तो शायद से ऊपर ऊपर एमबीआर के टैंक पे तैरता रहेगा, बट सिंस यू आर टेकिंग आउट वाटर थ्रू द फाइबर्स और थ्रू द शीट, तो क्लियर वाटर जो आपका बाहर निकल रहा है वो कंसिस्टेंटली रहेगा. बट स्लज बल्किंग या स्लज का जो डिपोजिशन है वो शायद से आपके एमबीआर के टैंक में थोड़ा एक्युमुलेट होता रहेगा. तो टेम्पररी यस योर प्लांट विल नॉट गेट चोक, कंसिस्टेंटली यू विल गेट द सिमिलर वाटर क्वालिटी बट हाँ इस इश्यू को आपको सर्टन टाइम पे एड्रेस तो करना पड़ेगा. तो कंपेयर टू अदर टेक्नोलॉजी जहाँ पे ट्यूब सेटलर क्लैरिफायर्स प्रोवाइड किए गए उसके कंपेयर में दिस इज द एज एक एक्स्ट्रा एडवांटेज आपको मिल जाता है. सिक्योरली मीट नॉर्म्स ऑफ द पॉल्यूशन कंट्रोल बोर्ड. सर्टनली अगर आप स्ट्रिंजेंट नॉर्म्स की बात करें तो एमबीआर कैन डिलीवर कंसिस्टेंट वाटर क्वालिटी एंड ट्रीटेड एफ्लुएंट कैन बी यूज फॉर द प्लांट इरिगेशन गार्डन फिशिंग एंड एचवीएसी. तो वी आर डिस्कसिंग व्हाई एमबीआर. If you are going to recycle the water, if you are looking for a class A water quality, certainly MBR is for you. Provided aap 100% water recycle kar rahe. Most of the time we see that ki 5 lakh liter ka treatment plant design kiya hai. Recycling mujhe 100 ya 150 meter cube hi karna hai. Aur balance 300 ya 350 meter cube ka jo pani wo aapko discharge karna hai. Us tarike ke cases mein MBR may not be commercially viable for all of you. But client is very quality conscious. We can, you can evaluate two technology for them. Fewer process to achieve comparable effluent quality. So if you see that we have reduced the number of process tank. So primary level पे जो tanks सारे वो आ रही हैं, तो आपका सिर्फ एक aeration tank हो रहा है और दूसरा आपका MBR tank हो रहा है. So we don't require any kind of you know holding tank, then sand filter carbon, then filter water storage tank. फिल्टर वाटर स्टोरेज टैंक के बाद अगेन हम लोग पंप करके अल्ट्रा फिल्ट्रेशन में डालते हैं, फिर अल्ट्रा फिल्ट्रेशन का एक स्टोरेज टैंक बनाया, देन वी आर इंस्टॉलिंग अ हाइड्रोन्यूमेटिक सिस्टम. तो द प्रोसेस इज वेरी लॉन्ग. उस प्रोसेस को कम से कम आप 40% तक रिड्यूस कर सकते हैं बाय प्रोवाइडिंग दिस टेक्नोलॉजी एंड विद द कंसिस्टेंट वाटर क्वालिटी. सो दीज आर द फ्यू एडवांटेजेस फॉर द सिलेक्शन ऑफ योर एमबीआर वेस्ट वाटर. ट्रीटेड विद अ वाटर पैरामीटर. I would definitely say MBR is always winner compared to any other technology. Turbidity 1 can be achieved with the ultrafiltration MBR. SDI 3 can be achieved with the ultrafiltration MBR. TSS 1, BOD 5, 30, COD. Ammonical nitrogen, not 0.5, it could be around 1 to 2. Total nitrogen can be less than 5 also with this some process. Total phosphorus. Total phosphorus is not related to any kind of MBR or any kind of technology. As per like few tenders which we are doing as an EPC contractor, for the phosphorus reduction they are asking for a certain kind of chemical dosing. So you have to provide some oxidation chemicals for the reduction of the total phosphorus. So total phosphorus is not related to MBR. It's required for all other technology and can be reduced by the various chemical dosing system. अगर हम लोग टेक्निकल कंपैरिजन इन टर्म्स ऑफ फ्लो चार्ट देखते हैं, आपको फ्लो में क्या क्या चाहिए, तो दिस अ टिपिकल आइटम व्हिच आई हैव रिटन डाउन ऑन अ लेफ्ट साइड. बार स्क्रीनिंग यू रिक्वायर, ऑयल एंड ग्रीस डेफिनेटली इट्स कंपलसरी फॉर ऑल द प्रोसेस. इक्वलाइजेशन टैंक यू डेफिनेटली रिक्वायर. एनॉक्सिक टैंक ऑप्शनल, आई विल नॉट से कि नॉट रिक्वायर और रिक्वायर्ड. एनॉक्सिक टैंक इफ यू आर ऑप्टिंग फॉर द रिडक्शन ऑफ टोटल नाइट्रोजन यू हैव टू गो फॉर द एनॉक्सिक टैंक. And nowadays, it is a compulsory in most of the state. Aeration tank, certainly it is required. Settling tank or tube settler or secondary clarifier, conventional and MBBR, you definitely require. If we talk about the SBR, so sequential batch reactor is a single tank process. The similar tank can work as a aeration and settling. So you don't require an additional tank for the settling of the sludge. MBR, since we are providing a physical barrier inside the aeration tank or in a separate tank, we don't require any kind of clarification process. Pre-filtration tank. Tino process like conventional MBBR and SBR. When I say pre-filtration tank means, aap in Tino process ke andar sand filter and carbon filter provide karte hi hain. To jo settling tank se aapka pani overflow ke ek holding tank mein aa raha hai, wo aapko banana hi padega. और वहां से आप पंप करके सैंड फिल्टर या कार्बन फिल्टर के अंदर पानी को फीड कर दें. फिल्टर किया, फिर एक और फिल्टर वाटर स्टोरेज टैंक लिया, उसमें आपने दो पार्ट किए, एक पानी आपका गार्डन में चले गया और दूसरा पानी आपने डिसाइड किया कि मुझे रिसाइकल करना है, तो आपने फिर से एक अल्ट्रा फिल्ट्रेशन लगाया और अल्ट्रा फिल्ट्रेशन की फिर एक टैंक बनाई. तो ये टैंक आपको एमबीआर में बनाने की जरूरत नहीं है, क्योंकि एमबीआर ट्रीटेड वाटर को आप टैंक में स्टोर करके विच एक्ट एज अ फाइनल ट्रीटेड वाटर स्टोरेज टैंक, यू कैन इंस्टॉल अ हाइड्रोड्यूबेटिक सिस्टम एंड यू कैन डिस्ट्रीब्यूट वाटर टू द एनी ऑफ द एप्लीकेशन. स्लज होल्डिंग टैंक डेफिनेटली चारों के अंदर रिक्वायर्ड है, बट since MBR works with a very high MLFS, the quantity of the sludge compared to conventional sewage treatment plant will be lower by around 30%. So, agar main dimension ki baat karu ya footprint area ki baat karu, yes, sludge holding tank ka dimension compared to other technology, MBR mein will be slightly lower. Plant room, definitely we require plant room for the any treatment plant, but definitely if we talk about the footprint size, MBR will have a lesser or a small plant room. Functioning performance ke hum log baat karte hain in terms of reliability of technology, theek hai, sari technology reliable hai. Problem kya hota hai ki agar designing proper nahi hai to koi bhi technology function nahi karega. Nothing is going to work without proper designing. If your designing is correct, if installation is perfect, if operation is perfect, any technology is going to perform very well. Quality of the treated water, MBR is the most highest quality deliver in category comparison to all the technologies. Process kinetics, sari kinetics established because if your design is proper and operators are good, all the stabilities are there. Automation, conventional and MBBR can work with the same auto treating process, but Hitensha, I have seen your reason, but we'll take your question after this thing. So SBR is mainly preferred with the automatic operation, and MBR is also with the fully automatic. The reason behind that, SBR ke andar bhi aap ek single tank process ke andar aeration, filling, settling, decanting sab kar rahe hain. और उस प्रोसेस को सिस्टमेटिक ऑपरेट करने के लिए यू रिक्वायर सर्टेन काइंड ऑफ मिनी पीएलसी और कंट्रोलर और डिटेल पीएलसी विद द एचएमआई. द सेम थिंग इज एप्लीकेबल फॉर द एमबीआर टेक्नोलॉजी. एमबीआर के अंदर भी ये हो रहा है कि आपको जो मैंने फिल्ट्रेशन साइकिल्स बनाए थे, लाइक यू रिक्वायर सर्टेन काइंड ऑफ फिल्ट्रेशन साइज, लाइक 8 मिनट इज योर सक्शन एंड 2 मिनट इज योर क्लीनिंग. सो दैट फिल्ट्रेशन साइकिल कैन नॉट बी कंट्रोल्ड विद द मैनुअल ऑपरेशन. So any which way, if you are designing MBR based sewage treatment plant, I would strongly suggest that our controlling system has to be designed very properly with the proper PLC, with the good quality of HMI, and with the good logic. Your MBR is going to perform very well. Efficiency in terms of output quality, definitely your MBR is always better. Sophistication of the operation, yes. So MBR is a very sophisticated plant, because if you are not operating MBR properly, your MBR may be at risk. So for example, आप देखिए कि आपने 50 लाख का STP लगाया और उसमें आपका 25 लाख का तो MBR का cost हो रहा है. And if your client is not operating MBR properly, वो पूरा clog हो गया, जम गया, and he says कि यार 2 साल के बाद I need to replace my MBR. And you give quotation to them of the 25 lakh bucks, and he said, "Ki guys, I cannot replace 25 lakh ka MBR mein nahi kar sakta hu." And most of the thing kya hota hai, jo residential societies hoti jahan pe builder they install a treatment plant and they hand over to the society. And after 2 year, 3 year, you go to the society owner and give the quotation of the 25 lakh. No one is going to replace your MBR, and ultimately the agenda and purpose of the installing of the sewage treatment plant will get diluted. Commercial industries jahan pe revenue generate ho raha hai, you talk about the hotel, hospital and industries, they people are sensitivity because unka ek revenue generating model hai, so they are ready to invest the money for the replacement of the component. So MBR is a very sophisticated plant, because agar MBR choke hua to 50% replacement cost is involved in such kind of process. Manpower required for the operation, certainly quantity or number of manpower requirements less in MBR, but koi watchman ko hum laga de, it is a wrong approach. We should have a limited manpower, but the operator has to be skilled. He must have a good knowledge of the biology of the sewage treatment plant. He must be aware about the process and function of the ट्रीटमेंट प्लान, एंड ही शुड बी अवेयर कि किस तरीके के लॉजिक हैं और हम लोगों ने कहाँ कहाँ पे चेक पॉइंट्स दे रखे हैं. तो यस, एमबीआर के अंदर यू रिक्वायर सर्टन हाई लेवल एंड स्किल्ड ऑपरेटर, एंड स्पेसिफिकली इफ यूर प्लांट इज कनेक्टेड विद द एस्काडा सिस्टम, बिकॉज वेन यू टॉक अबाउट द एस्काडा बेस्ड सीवेज ट्रीटमेंट प्लान और वेस्ट वाटर ट्रीटमेंट प्लान, देयर विल बी नंबर ऑफ इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशन विल गेट इन्वॉल्व. इट कुड बी अ transmembrane pressure, pressure transmitter, a temperature control, DO meter will be there. सो इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशन फंक्शन ठीक तरीके से कर रहे हैं नहीं कर रहे हैं, we need a high skilled person to check those instruments. These are the functional performance comparison. Just technical comparison banaya, but this comparison for the smallest capacity of the sewage treatment plant. So we can design, I think you all can design STP with the MBI technology 10, and nowadays few members are available. Ki agar aap 5 KLD ka ek chota sa treatment plant pe design karna chahe with the MBI technology. Now commercial MBR membranes are available for the small capacity of the STP of 5 meter cube per day. So reason I am taking 10 KLD, because I think most of the time hame is capacity ke aas paas ke treatment plant ke requirements, sometimes it's more 10 to 50, 100, 120, 150 KLD is ideal. So if we talk about the conventional, it is almost higher side. So SBR normally, as per my calculation, is a more energy saving sewage treatment plant compared to any technology. The MBR consume more power compared to SBR. Consumable cost per month is always on a higher side in MBR, and I'm considering this chemical consumption and replacement of MBR also. Manpower dilution required, duration is required definitely. Since MBRs are fully automatic MBR, you require a less manpower only for the observation and for the cleaning of your screen chamber and oil and grease. Output quality consistently good in MBR compared to all technology. Moving part sabhi mein hote, we are using blowers, surface editors, decanters or various pump. So I think moving part we cannot avoid into the wastewater treatment plant. Overall operating cost is slightly lower in MBR. Yeah, I did. You know? Operational cost, this is based on the life cycle cost. If you consider cost per vehicle in the smallest capacity, I'm talking about the smallest. Do not consider this figure for the 100 or 200 meter cube. Overall operation cost, agar 500 meter cube pe baat karte hain, to this will be a very high. But for the smallest capacity, जहाँ पे आपकी pumping cost काफी हो जाती है, क्योंकि इंडिया में इतने छोटे pump available नहीं. If you are looking for a 5 KLD, 10 KLD, 20 KLD plant, आपका वही 1.1 kilowatt का pump 1 meter cube से 10 meter cube तक is going to function. The smallest the capacity, it consumes larger the energy, higher the energy. उस condition में भी MBI is a lower compared to other things. Maintenance cost is very very high in MBR. And why it is involved? Because the replacement of MBI is like definitely involved. So you have to be very choosy. You have to identify your customer, whether your customer is right for the MBI technology or not. क्योंकि सिर्फ देने से कुछ नहीं होगा. अगर client चला नहीं पाया तो भी उसके लिए difficult. 1 year spare maintenance ranging almost close, but definitely MBI is slightly higher होते हैं. Cost of civil work for the smaller capacity is almost goes down by 50% in case of MBR. So since your footprint is lower, your tank dimension goes down, the civil cost is lower, footprint is the smallest in MBR technology. And that's what is from my side. Any question? And we are open for the question. Any query or any technical data sheet you are looking for, so whatever data we have prepared with the IP team, we can share with you. Thank you so much. So we are, I'm going to unmute you all and you can go for the Q&A session.
Thank you. So I
mute all. So Minesh, main sirf aapko unmute kar lijiye.
Don't unmute. Okay. Those who want to ask a question, they should unmute themselves and ask a question.
Yeah, or you can also type in the chat box and we can go by one. So yeah, yeah. Comfortable. Yeah. So we'll have 10 minutes for the Q&A session, and then we have some announcement which Minesh sir is going to share with you. So guys,
what about the cost of replacement of the membrane after the life cycle cost?
Yeah, so like if I share the approximate figure, for example, MBR is normally now sold in a square meter cost. कि अगर मैं एक square meter की cost MBR के लेता हूँ, तो MBR cost is ranging from 3,000 rupees per square meter to 7,000 rupees per square meter. तो for example, 100 meter cube का plant है, and for the 100 meter cube, if my flux is, let's say, I am just calculating management, 2 minutes. So 5,000 liter per hour, 20 LMH per design. So we require 250 square meter for the 100 cubic meter of plant. Now current rate of MBR 250 square meter is around 11.25 rupees. So 11.5 lakh rupees would be a replacement cost of MBR for the 100 cubic meter of plant. Which comes around 11,000 rupees per cubic meter. अगर हम लोग life cycle cost की बात करें तो.
Okay. Then one question was that we are using the air for cleaning, right?
Yeah.
We are blowing in air.
Yes.
And not the oxygen.
So oxygen is definitely required for the aeration process.
Right. But, so what is the efficiency? What is the efficiency of the blower for the of blowing on the air?
ब्लोवर की एफिशिएंसी तो डिपेंड कर रहा है कि हम लोग ब्लोवर किस प्रेशर पे और किस मैन्युफैक्चरर का सेलेक्ट कर रहे हैं और उनकी मोटर की एफिशिएंसी क्या है. बट नॉर्मली अगर मैं एमबीआर के रिक्वायरमेंट की बात करूं तो फॉर एग्जांपल आपने 100 मीटर क्यूब का अभी हम लोगों ने एग्जांपल लिया था. सो 250 स्क्वायर मीटर का अगर मेरा एमबीआर है तो एयर स्कोरिंग रिक्वायरमेंट फॉर द होलो फाइबर वुड बी अराउंड 75 मीटर क्यूब पर आवर. Is the air demand for the 250 square meter in MBR hollow fiber. If you go for the flat sheet, then that would be around almost 150 meter cube per hour. So hollow fiber is 75, and we talk about the flat sheet, that would be around 150 cubic meter per hour. In that way, flat sheet consume require more air, so it's less energy efficient compared to hollow fiber.
Any other questions from any of the participants?
Gentlemen, can I talk now?
Yeah, you can talk.
Yeah, I am Bhaskar from Hyderabad.
Mr.
Vinod, my question is, how is your experience with the flat sheet versus hollow fiber sheets in the overall life cycle?
So, I have personally used both the membrane and I have visited few oldest plants in both the cases. If I talk about the domestic sewage application, my experience with both the membranes is good. Like I have seen the oldest plant, which was done by the G, and earlier G has taken over another company in 2006 and 7. So first plant, which was done by G in 2007, I have visited them, their plant in 2015 and 16. It was performing well. Flat sheet installation, we have around in Ahmedabad, there is a 2 MLD centralized effluent treatment plant is in Changodar, which is running since 2011. The initial membrane was supplied by the Kubota, Japan.
Kubota, yes.
Yeah. And I think it's almost 9 years and the CETP is working well with the flat sheet membrane. But the flat sheet was designed, I remember, it is around 11 to 12 LMH.
Okay. Then one more question, just generally a practical question I'm asking.
Yeah.
When your hardness is higher to the tune of around almost 1000 ppm.
Yes, yes.
What's your experience in MBRs?
I have a slightly not good experience with the higher salt contamination and higher hardness. I have seen one plant in Ankleshwar, which is a part of Gujarat. And I have seen one installation of MBR. Hollow fiber in chemical industries where high contamination was coming. And even though that plant was designed around 10 to 12 LMH, still the plant was not functioning well. And when they went for the detailed analysis and research, they found that some kind of salt is getting deposited on the MBR surface with the combination of some of their non-productive chemical.
So my last question, if you permit.
Yeah, carry on. Bhaskar. Yes. To your question on 1000 ppm hardness, yes. The first thing is with 1000 ppm of the hardness, all your water supply, all your piping systems and everything are going on a toss.
No, there we can always think of non-metallic. There are some challenges have come to us, some of the customers are asking. Okay, they are basically like, as for the middle of construction point of view, we can choose the middle of construction of the pipes. No issues at all.
Right.
The question is that these are the things where basically that permanently it gets stuck on the layer of the membrane, where that's one of the biggest problem which I'm pursuing with a couple of companies.
No, that's correct. So that's my statement was that since in cases where you are having higher hardnesses,
yes,
the first thing should be the water should be treated at source.
Yes.
Fresh water should be treated so as to lower down on the hardness.
Yes.
And then your sewage also has the lesser hardness.
I appreciate, sir. Basically, some of the industrial projects are coming out where this kind of a challenges.
Yeah, that's true. Okay. Industrial projects will have such challenges.
Some kind of a challenges where, like, only the water, because of the non-availability of the things and all, this water will be used for various cooling
towers and
other applications.
That is correct.
Like how? That's one of the applications. Right. The last question I'm talking is, today scenario, like Supreme Court rule, advises and all, it has to be less than 10 ppm of output levels, BOD.
Hmm.
Where like currently either you use SBR or other technologies along with the UF, which will be coming closer. Otherwise, the only option is MBR to get the particular results, consistency of the results. What's your opinion on that, sir?
Yeah. So, Mr. Bhaskar, your question is very right. If we want to achieve a less than 10 BOD,
yes.
And I have seen many plants which was designed by the Indian company and few equipment were supplied by the European companies. And even though without ultrafiltration, they are getting less than 10 BOD. But the problem was that the 10 BOD is not consistently.
Exactly.
So 10 BOD aaj aata hai, like in the 24 hour. But if you talk about Vinod, we are looking for a consistent 10 BOD water. Whenever I check round the clock 24 hour, that's difficult. That is possible. If you're looking for consistency, ultrafiltration or MBR is a must.
Can I add here, sir?
Yeah, please, sir.
See, because it's a discussion is just going on. Okay, I am also in the business of water treatment, sewage treatment.
Okay.
Where I would have supplied more than 200 numbers of SBR plants of bigger sizes.
Okay.
Okay, and we are confirming to the customers that at least 8 to 9 times out of BOD.
Sir,
okay, BOD will be less than 10, but so one or two times it can slip. It can slip.
Yeah.
It can slip one or two times. That also purely because of the inlet water quality. Sometimes they may not be properly maintaining their oil and grease traps and all the stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So this kind of challenges are there, but at some people says that with SBR it has to be 100 out of 100 times it has to come, which is not practical. What is your comment on that?
So if you talk about the specifically on the SBR technology,
yes,
and concerning to the output parameter specifically for the BOD and COD,
yes.
So I don't want to name a company, but they have done around more than 700 installations in India, specifically in the municipal size of the plant, ranging from 10 MLD to 150 MLD. So mm-hmm. whenever they are doing government projects, they claim and they fulfill their claim by delivering consistently less than 5 to 7 BOD only with the SBR technology. Mm-hmm. And they say that since their equipment are so precisely designed, specifically their decanters and biological process, so this is, if you are opting for a less than 5 BOD, we are comfortable even without the ultrafiltration. So now, this...
Very nice.
This, yeah, so this point is slightly... goes to the now manufacturing point of view or designing point of view. Some manufacturers says ki no, SBR cannot deliver 5, and two companies says yes, it is possible to deliver the less than 5 BOD. So
can I interrupt?
Yeah, please.
Yeah, Bhaskarji, basically Bhaskarji, Vinodji, basically in any type of a treatment plant of STP, when we are talking about consistency in terms of outlet parameters, it's mainly, in cases like, we have done some plants wherein they have added certain amount of analyzers online. And those analyzers are directly connected to the PLC, wherein the, amount of air which is given in or, it is reduced or increased on the basis of these type of parameters because of which this type of a consistent outlet parameter can be, you know, achieved. You know, CTEC is the best example of SBR. So you know it.
Yes, I
mean, so they have their own PLC. No, it's a very, popular company. So it's not a case scenario.
Yes, I was referring to the same company.
Yeah, yeah. It has its own PLC, which is designed on the basis of DO analyzers and the outlet parameters, because of which, you know, you can get consistent results. But as we say in municipal, corporation STPs, the major problem which comes in is the pumping station. When we are taking the water from a pumping station, we don't know what exactly is the parameter concentration which we are going to get in the input. That's going to give a case scenario.
Yes.
Agreed, Sagarji. Well said.
Yes, Sagar.
Thank you.
Inlet water is always important. Inlet water quality, inlet sewage quality is always important.
Exactly.
And in municipal sewages, that is always a question mark on the inlet water quality.
My point is there. No, I want to ask.
Sir, your voice is echoing like anything.
I will check.
I think just a moment. Yeah, please.
Yes, sir, now it's okay.
Better than before.
Your voice is echoing.
Okay. Now it's okay, sir?
No, it's still
okay, sir?
Still okay.
Sir.
Better than before, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Now it's okay, sir?
Yeah, better.
So my point is very simple. How much side water depth minimum you want to recommend?
Okay. So for MBR technology, sir?
Total surface area is required. If side water depth is higher, surface area might be lesser. So how much side water depth minimum and maximum you can recommend?
Okay. For MBR tank, precisely if I talk, they are standard sizes of MBR. The minimum height available of MBR frame, sheet
including
frame, is ranging from 1.5 meter to 4.5 meter. Mm-hmm. So when I talk about 4.5
meter, it means 4.5 meter, very less companies provided.
Yeah,
1.5 is average, and maximum, average. We can say 2.5 meter.
Of course. So like 1.5, then 2.5, then 1.5 to 3 meter, and then 4.5 meter. So yes, the higher
it's
the
very less for like, higher capacity plant.
Correct. So like my observation is if our height of the frame is smaller, let's say we are talking about the 1.5 meter height. Now in that condition, the cassette height will be around 1.1 or 1.2 meter. It means we are talking about the low height of the MBR sheet. Now, if we select the low height of the MBR, the bottom of the MBR will be more prone for the clogging.
Definitely. Yeah. I want to ask, what is the minimum height, side water depth required?
It's
2.5, 3 meters or?
Side water depth, you talk about 3.5 meters, then the height of the MBR should be between 2.5 to 3 meters.
Oh, thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you. So nice of you.
We know there is one question by Mr. Avinash Verma on the chat.
Okay.
What he says is that a settler is not required in this MBR. If we want to install for additional safety, can we do that?
So I'm trying to understand his question, Manish bhai.
I think you have said that a settling tank is not required for MBR.
Yes.
But if you want to install for additional safety, can we do that? That's what I mean. Avinash Verma is asking.
Yeah. Avinash, a good question, but yes, you can certainly provide, but provide it. Like, so your additional settling tank can work as a firefighting system. Like, your MBR is completely clogged and you don't have any option to replace the MBR, or your user don't want to replace the MBR, or any kind of problem where your plant is not performing due to clogging of the MBR. So certainly we can provide some kind of diverting line to the settling tank. Sludge can get settled on. We can get a certain good quality of the water. But since you will not be having the sand filter, carbon filter, the designing of the settling tank is very important, so that at least you can match your 20 or 30 BOD level. So it's optional, and if you do that, it's a good choice.
When Mr. Milind Seven Savant has asked, how many pumps will be there in the system?
So ideally, three pump is good for the MBR design. Why three pump? Because sometimes what happens, let's say we design a 500 cubic meter of the plant. So you may go for the two cassette of the MBR, let's say 250 square meter two plant or 100 square meter two MBR. So two pump for the two dedicated cassette and one is a standby. So preferred combination for the MBR suction pump is 2+1.
Okay, those are the questions on the chat box. Any other questions?
I have one question.
Yeah, Mr. Sagar. Yeah.
The first question is that basically when we are talking about, you know, vacuum pumps for the MBR cassettes, so what is the actual designing perspective behind it? I mean, is it on the basis of the flow or something like that? And the second question is, in such kinds of, you know, systems, as you have seen a lot of STPs, what happens to the septage, that is a fecal sludge? So is it coming in the MBR tank or is it already separated behind?
So answer to your first question, which is very important, Sagar bhai. Like if we designed this the self-priming pump or vacuum pump for the MBRs, two things are very important. Number one is the flow rate. Because sometimes kya hota hai ki your MBR is designed on the flux rate. So you designed your MBR on, let's say, 15 liter per square meter multiplied by, let's say, 100, so around 1.5 cubic meter of the per hour. But your pump higher head might be 2 meter cube, 3 meter cube, 4 meter cube per hour, probably. So the best design of the pump, I would technically recommend if your pump is associated with the flow transmitter or flow controlling wall. So first thing, it assures ki your MBR is working on your design flux. कि मैंने 15 LMH पे design किया तो MBR से 15 LMH पर ही flow निकल रहा है. Point number one. Second is your transmembrane pressure, which is called your differential pressure between your MBR sheets. So if TMP is designed properly, let's say manufacturer claim ranging TMP ranging from 0.3 to 0.7. So that TMP meter has to be at the suction point of the pump, and that TMP has to be connected with your PLC with the logic. If my TMP is 0.7 to 0.9, pe hoga, so it's time to CIP of your MBR. So clean these are the two criteria for the pump. Your second question, I am trying to understand, if you can septage, it means a settled sludge of the septic tank or just
No. I'm talking about the actual fecal sludge coming in with the water.
Okay, so now fecal sludge will definitely disturb the biology of your wastewater, because my understanding with the fecal sludge is a very high burine study. Like, we are doing two fecal sludge treatment plant in the Uttar Pradesh, and as per report, the
sir, should I intervene?
Yeah, Mr. Jakesh.
Sir, basically, fecal sludge means high sludge content. BOD may be less than 100. Reason being, anaerobic process is there, so BOD may be less than or nearby 100, but sludge contents are more than ordinary, we can say TSS. Ordinary TSS may be inlet around 400 ppm, but in fecal sludge, it may be in percentage, means 5 to 6%. So it may be again matter of fouling.
I agree with education, rightly said. So fecal, like if you have, so you must be working with the fecal sludge treatment plant tenders floated by the government. So they are providing three characteristics of the fecal, which is volume wise and jo aapne kaha, which is a percentage wise. So sometimes very dense fecal is coming, like old septic tank of 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, and you are taking out through the vacuum system and disposing to the centralized fecal sludge treatment plant. In that condition, the volume is very high. But if you're talking about the a normal sewage, like exhibition is happening or some Kumbh Melas are there, and we are taking that fecal, so you're right, the water volume is more, sludge quantity is less, like 4 to 5%. You're absolutely right.
Normally, so when case, I design the plants.
Yes, Sagar ji.
Yeah. Sagar
sir, in that case, if you want to add fecal sludge or septic sludge, first you diverted the sludge, then filtrate may be transferred into your STP, and that sludge can be separate and like in digester or anywhere.
True. No, the thing is that when we are talking about, you know, municipal wastewater, many a times it is the case that the sewage lines are directly connected to the drainage. And that time we are not able to control the amount of, you know, fecal sludge which comes in. Furthermore, when we are talking about septic sludge which is coming in through the vacuum vehicle,
that water,
whatever I have observed up till date, it's, yeah, if we separate it, it's containing a COD of around 6,000 to 8,000. That's what I have come across. And that's why I was more interested in seeing the, whether MBR is working in those conditions. So I understand that we have to separate the fecal matter first and then we have to go for the supernatal treatment. That's clear. For
I think it's a separate thing.
Like, can I come in?
Next time we can
sorry, friends. But the reality, I think so, all of you need to go to web. Just see the connect to the Central Pollution Control Board site. Or even Center of Science and Environment site, you will come to know that which plant and what efficiency and what removal. They have comprehensive report across the country with various capacities and the performance with every small parameter, even we don't know. Even I am sorry to criticize this, but even see, most of the people don't know how to even take the sample. See, inlet sample, even the tank sample, outlet sample, and all samples, and even how to carry it to the lab and then to analyze it. That is one point. Secondly, see, the fundamental thing which is missed, we are trying to say that biomass, which is created out of 10,000 processes in the globe, basically means through biology or photosynthesis, or even then in factory we have made, let us say, sugar, and we are trying to say just putting in the plant and keeping it in for 12 hours or 14 hours we will get the result. My dear friend, you go to the details of activated sludge, that black powder you are getting, you analyze it, you will come to know it is not at all carbon. It is not degraded to carbon. Even your presentation is silent on biomass degradation, biomass, bioreactor. What is the role of bacteria? See, membrane is, you are talking about filtration. We are talking about biological reactor. It is 100% missing. And adding nitrogen, you are complexing the sewage. See, you are not only complexing, because one side we have a carbon cycle, other side we have a nitrogen cycle. By adding air, you are adding 80% nitrogen into the plant water, and diffusion of nitrogen is creating maximum problem when you are adding before the tank. So I have three questions. Please read the reports of CPCB and CAC and NGT. All orders have gone against the all STP people. All industry are closing down, and today why everything is clean? Because the nonsense has stopped. Everyone is trying to hide. Even the question of Bhaskar was very right. Chlorination is ineffective the minute we had higher TDS or higher hardness. So all these technical and principles are missing. See, what is the role of bacteria? Which bacteria is going to do the degradation? Which is most important?
So Apurbhai, sorry to interrupt you. Today, I think we were talking about the MBR. If you want to take a session dedicated on the biology,
MBR, biological reactor, I am asking.
I agree with you. Today we were talking about the how MBR function. I would request Chairman Mr. Minesha.
Function is done by bacteria, no degradation.
Agreed. If you want to cover
degradation, you are not covering. That is not fair.
If you want to cover a biology, you take one more session. I would request Mr. Minesha to keep another section on the biology. We will not talk about the technology. We will only talk about the biology of the system. If you decide a particular subject, like today we are going to talk on the MBR system, anybody will talk about the MBR system and ask a question about that. If you are talking about the biology, let's keep an association.
Keep apart there too. Why CPCB and CAC is saying against all MBR and SBR?
Sir,
why it is not working? Why NGT orders are against you? Why they are changing parameters?
So you
what
talk
is BOD-5? BOD-5 is what? Define BOD-5.
Okay, you talk to Mr. Vijay Nera, Ahmedabad Municipal Commissioner. He has floated 15 tender on the MBR set. You talk to the committee on that. That I think they would be able to reply you properly. I cannot. Sorry.
No, but CPCB and CSE is wrong bodies. GPCB has been given order on 1st April. You won't. I can share the copy. LMB Alembic Pharma, United Phosphorus in Ankleshwar are told to pay 10 crore rupee.
I'm in agreement of your all the points. If this is forum for that, we are open for that. Mr. Minesh, yeah. Please comment.
No, we need to talk more scientific
principles
whereby we can improve the society's future. See, right now, what we are talking is incomplete and partially incorrect. My only contention is to have something which is solid.
Agreed.
Which is scientific.
You identify one topic and subject and let's have open discussion on that. I am completely okay for that. Let's talk
about biology. Let us have a separate session on this.
I'll share one report with you, Vinod. In a couple of days, you can go through that report and even CPCB link. Go through the report. They have talked about all technology, maintenance, capex, everything. And why it is not working, they have highlighted even. And that this report is 2014 and this report I am talking CSE, which is 2019. And that plants across India, not one place.
Agreed.
And 20 samples, means inlet, outlet and all season. Means January, February, March, April, like that analysis is something which is need of an hour, which none of the manufacturer I have seen has talked about.
Okay, so we can keep a session for that. Minesh, I have a request to keep a session.
We can have a separate session on this. Yeah. Meanwhile, Vinod, there are a couple of questions on what we have presented.
Yeah, please.
Sahil Kansal has asked that, what he says is this, is there a chance that membrane might get damaged in lack of sewage?
Yes, because if there is no sewage, there is no MLHS, you are giving frequently high aeration with the high pressure. Yes, there are chances fiber may get damaged.
And there is a second question from Mr. Arthur Prakash. What he says is that what is the minimum sewage load required to run an MBR system?
So ideally, I think we all face this problem. And again, with all the technology, 20 to 25% sewage is mandatory minimum to operate plant in efficient way. The because reason is that MBR always demand very high MLHS, around 5 to 6,000 MLHS. With the lower inflow or lower sewage quantity, you will not be able to develop higher MLHS. You require
in case of lockdown, MBR will not work for the mall.
Yeah, that was the second. That was the question I was going to ask.
You're right.
So 50 lakh pani mein.
So Vinod, in that case, Vinod, what is the solution in that case? Say, for example, in this lockdown scenario. What would be the SOP for running the MBR plant? I mean any STP. Then in that case, the entire plant has to be recommissioned.
Yeah. Also, my opinion for MBR and MBBS, definitely I think recommissioning will be required. For the SBR,
I think that's a question which is not justified to your lecture, because basically MBR is a physical separation.
Yeah.
Any type of treatment plant which is running on a biological treatment, if it is stopped for, aerobic, if it is stopped for say one day and more, it has to be automatically re-stabilized when it has to be started again. Okay. So MBR, probably if it is, submerged in fresh water and kept as it is without running, it may have a proper sensible scenario. But for the aerobic system, yes, aerobic we system. Have to stabilize it.
So here I am specifically asking about the MBR plant.
Then MBR, we have to just submerge it and let it as it is. Usko bas dry nahi rakhna hai. That's what, if I am not wrong, Vinod bhai.
Yeah, so like if we keep the MBR in the, even into fresh water and it's not dry, it can be. But the Minesh bhai question ki, do we need to go for the recommissioning? I say, like, I think we have to go for the recommissioning of the treatment plant.
Okay, any other questions from anyone on this today's presentation? We'll be having a separate session on what Apurav bhai was talking on. And I also send an information on the WhatsApp chat to everyone on for a webinar on 9th of April, that is on Thursday, day after tomorrow, on a very important topic. This topic is going to cover what will the scenario post our lockdown, how the small businesses should prepare for restart after the lockdown. And this will be taken up by Mr. Rajiv Chawla, He was a chairman of IMSME of India and a board of director of Haryana MSME, and also a governing body of QSI, the Quality Council of India. So let us have a good webinar on this on coming Thursday.
Yeah. So guys, I would request all of you to attend, because the Mr. Rajiv Chawla has been a mentor of more than 6,000 industries of North India. He has cultivated tiny industry to the medium large size of company. And he is going to talk about specifically how to manage your cash flow. Because once the lockdown gets open, our inflow will be very lower and our outflow will be very high. So how to manage the cash flow? What are the payments and deferment policies has been floated by the Reserve Bank of India and governments? So I think that will be very good on a business point of view. So the IP Ahmedabad chapter has decided to bring that speaker for specifically for all of us. Do join us. He's a very thorough person.
Vinod, there is one question from Sahil. I think he's feeling shy. He's not asking you directly. He's writing on the chat. What he's saying is, how can you are talking of sharing the calculations. How can he get the calculations?
My email ID, if you want to write, Mr. Sahil, it's Vinod, V-I-N-O-D, Vinod. Or you can message to Mr. Minesh, and Mr. Minesh, I will share.
Anyone requiring any detail can write to me, to my email ID, ahmedabad@indianplumbing.org.
Yes.
And we will provide that. One more question, Vinod. I think this session was recorded by you.
Yeah, it is a recorded session. I will share the link on a Google Drive.
Yeah, so you can share the link, which we can pass on to everyone.
Sure, and I will also share this presentation with all of you guys.
Sir, the day after tomorrow, at what time is that, sir? Same 5 o'clock?
So, 4:30.
4:30 tomorrow, Mr. Bhaskar.
4:30 to 6, Bhaskar.
Okay, thank you very much.
And it will be a good session, because Mr. Rajiv Chawla is a nice chap.
Without fail, definitely, yes.
Yep.
Thank you.
See you on Thursday.
Thanks a lot, personally to you. You have done a great job. Thanks a lot.
Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot for the support.
Bye-bye. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Minesh. Thank you all for listening. And anything is there, please connect to Mr. Minesh and the chapter. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Vinod.
Chalo, Vinod.
Yes, sir. Chalo, see you. Okay.
Apurubhai hai ki nikal gaya. Apurubhai ka session rakhte hai. We can have one session on that.
Let's keep one session on this biology. That will be great, sir.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you so much. Yeah, thank you all. Bye.